Hello everyone, this is Caleb Simpson here from ZeldaDungeon.net, showing you how to find all 27 goddess cubes and their respective treasure chest found within The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. As an alternative to following this video, you can also check out this same guide on our website, and that may be a little more helpful if you're trying to track down which ones you have and which ones you don't have, so it may be a little easier. If you're watching this on YouTube, there is a link in the description. So as you are traveling through the deep woods for the first time, you'll encounter Gorko studying a random blue block in the middle of nowhere. The game forces you to talk to him, and he will not let you leave until you use this particular cube. They force this one down your throat. You can't do anything about it. So he rambles for a while, but the summary is just that you can hunt down these goddess cubes and then use a Skyward Strike on them, and it will send magical energy to the sky, activating chests that hold prizes. Yay! We all love prizes. So they're going to just appear somewhere in either Skyloft or on random islands in the sky. So basically, the developers made a collection system that gives them an excuse to make that empty sky feel a little more adventurous and unlock things as you progress. It's actually kind of a cool system. I'd much prefer this as opposed to just not having anything in the sky in general. But anyway, once you can, you want to stand next to the cube, charge up your sword by holding it straight up, and then slash at the cube to make it all glowy. This will make it disappear, and then Gorko will talk to you more. Anyway, so this will activate a chest in the sky, and it's up on Pumpkin Landing, just outside the Lumpy Pumpkin front door. It contains an adventure pouch slot, which will come in very handy. It allows you to carry more things in your pouch at once, and eventually you will have tons of items, so this is very helpful. The second goddess cube is very close to the first one you saw. They practically hand this one to you. It's just outside the Skyview Temple, directly south of it. Again, this is right next to the previous goddess cube, so you'll probably got both of them at the same time. The related chest is on a small island just west of Pumpkin Landing, all by its lonesome, and because their cubes are so close together, you're probably getting this and the previous chest at the same time. This is one of the first pieces of heart that is available in the game, so if you're collecting all of them, you should be able to have a whole heart container in time for the Skyview Temple boss, which is pretty cool. The third goddess cube is at the end of the Skyview Temple itself, just past the boss room in the spring behind the temple. So you go back there, and it's behind the goddess statue thingy where you got the ruby tablet. Anyway, if you did not get this earlier when you were at the Skyview Temple, don't worry, because you can always return to the Skyview Temple, go back through it, and go to the spring, and in fact, almost halfway through the game, you actually return to the Skyview Temple anyway, so that's a very convenient time to get it if you missed it the first time, although if you're past that point too, then you're just kind of out of luck, and you're just going to have to go through that just for the heck of it. Now, the chest for this is on top of a roof in the Lumpy Pumpkin above the front door. It contains a gold rupee, so just make sure you have enough wallet space to hold it, because you may need to spend some money at Beetle Shop or purchase some wallet upgrades before you open this chest so that you don't waste any of those rupees, because that would be a shame. This next cube is at the Elden Volcano entrance. As soon as you get there, just run straight forward and drop off the ledge to find it. This one's pretty easy. I would be surprised if any of you didn't see this the first time. This activates a chest on a small island just south of Thunderhead, near Fun Fun Island. It contains a small seed satchel, which are the seeds that you use for the slingshot. That probably would have been a little more helpful for the previous dungeon, but oh well, it's still cool. Pretty early on in the Elden Volcano adventure, you discover bomb flowers, and right past that you go past a bird statue, and you'll come to this fork in the road where it goes multiple directions, and if you just keep going straight, then you'll come to a dead end, and you'll find a goddess cube. Yay! The chest for this one is on top of an island between Bamboo Island and Beetles Island in the top right corner of the sky, and it holds a silver rupee, which is worth 100. Yeah. Once you've drained the lava from the central area in the Elden Volcano, you'll gain access to the central volcano thing with an air geyser leading up to it. You want to use A to dash off the ledge so that you're gliding once you're inside the mountain, and you want to aim down to land on this little platform in the top right corner where you'll find a goddess cube. If you mess up, don't worry, because there is a nearby air geyser thing down here that you can jump into that will take you back to the surface, so you can try again. So you can do this repeatedly until you get it. Unfortunately, although this cube is available pretty early in the game, the related chest is inside Thunderhead. But don't worry, though, we will gain access to it later in the game. So at first you will not be able to access this, but that's fine, we will be able to get it later. Now the next cube is close to the Earth Temple entrance. There are some bomb flowers that are just west of it, and there's an air geyser here as well. You want to toss one of the bomb flowers into it, and it will fly upwards to those boulders that are up there, and it's just begging to be explodified. So just wait till that explodes, and afterwards fly up yourself and claim your cube. This activates a chest that is on the Bamboo Island, just behind the building, and it has a gold rupee inside. Now, you probably have enough wallet space by now, but just make sure you have enough room before you open it so that you don't waste potential rupees. This next goddess cube is pretty close to the last one. Just east of the Earth Temple entrance is a little Bokoblin village or something. All these little tents. After you have slaughtered them all, you want to run to the back and then follow this ramp downwards to find a goddess cube at the bottom. Now the chest that is unlocked is on a small island in the far top right corner of the sky, just south of Beetle's Island. This one's a bit tricky. You need to land on the upper portions of the island, and then you'll notice that there are some vines that are leading off the edge up here. You want to stand close to them, press A to drop down, and then follow them to reach an alcove with a chest. The prize is a treasure medal, which makes treasure appear more frequently when you're carrying it. This is great for getting things like jelly blobs, monster claws, ornamental skulls when you kill enemies, etc. So it's pretty cool. Within Elden, there's a giant sand slide off to the far east, and as you slide down it, you want to go to the left and touch the air geyser to get on top of the platform. You want to look off the edge straight ahead, and then drop down onto the smaller island in front of you, where there is a goddess cube. Yeah! Now, although this cube can be activated pretty early in the game, and a lot of you probably did, the corresponding chest is unfortunately in Skyloft, inside the storage shed, and is unreachable until later. No! Don't worry, we will be able to get this later though, and I will show you when that is available. Now the next cube is at the very entrance of the Lanayru region at the start of the Lanayru mine. As soon as you land, you want to turn around and go behind the tower to find our blue block friend. Now the chest for this one is on an island we were at not too long ago at the far top right corner of the sky. At the front of the island this time, you want to drop down and use your bomb to blow up the wall blocking the cave entrance, which is hiding a chest. Haha, you can't hide from us. It grants you a whopping 100 rupees. Amazing. Kind of ironic that we get several gold rupees early on, but most of the silver rupees are acquired later when you actually have wallet space, but whatever. Now, as you're passing through the Lanayru Desert, you'll reach this area off to the far west that's filled with sand. You have to kill the Amphilus with bombs, so you can either roll them across the sand, or you can use the hook beetle to get the bomb flowers that are on top of the trees here. And then you want to use the Amphilus shells to work your way across the sand and claim the goddess cube in the corner. Now, this chest is found on top of the volcano island on the outer edge of it, and it contains a heart metal, which makes your makes recovery hearts appear more often. If you're playing on the hard mode, this is the only way to make recovery hearts appear normally. Once you reach the Temple of Time, there's a point where you'll have to save a robot from some Bokoblins, and after you activate the Time Shift Stone nearby, you'll be able to ride the minecart to get to the other side. On top of this island in the middle, there is a goddess cube that you can only strike while riding in the minecart. You have more than enough time to charge it up, and even if you mess up, don't worry because you can always just hop in the minecart again and try again. But now, by using the beetle to hit the time shift stone, you could easily return here later to get it as well. And that I would take the north way to get here as opposed to going through all those other minecarts. That's just a pain. But you can get there by dropping down to the North Desert labeled bird statue, and then you can go activate that. Anyway, this activates a chest on top of Beetle's Island in the top right corner of the sky, which has a piece of heart inside. Yeah! Now, after the Lanayru mining facility, you'll go on a little mission that eventually opens up Thunderhead, allowing you to explore inside. At long last, we can finally snag that chest for the goddess cube we found in Elden Volcano. It's near the base of the Isle of Songs on the right side, and it contains a gold rupee. Yes! A little after that, we return to Faron to get the Water Dragon Scale. This item allows you to swim in water. Ho-ho! So with our newfound ability, you can then return to Skyloft and get that chest that was inside the storage shed. Haha, you can't hide from us anymore. To reach it, just jump into the water and swim through the opening underneath the windmill. This underwater passageway leads to the inside of the shed where the two chests awaits. The regular chest contains a silver rupee, while the goddess chest has a piece of heart. A little after you get the Water Dragon Scale, you'll begin climbing up the great tree here in Faron Woods. Now once you get to the bird statue that is on the tree, you want to save there, and then you can, from then on, you can use this bird statue to get up on top of the tree whenever you jump down. You just go to the sky and then come back down using the statue, and it will save a lot of time. There are three goddess cubes that we can get up here, and the first one is back through this opening. So just go right through here, through the tree, and emerge on the other side. Now on your map, you can mark the location with a beacon if you that would be easier for you, but it's on the far west side, on one of these upper platforms that extend away from the tree. Now from here, you can jump down and reach it. Now I recommend you do this only after you've activated the bird statue, because that way you can just go to the sky and return to the statue instead, saving a lot of climbing, especially because the enemies will reappear. It's kind of a pain. Now the chest for that cube is in Skyloft atop a little island to the west. To get it, you need to dash off the nearby platform and tilt the Wiimote to glide to the island. It only has a silver rupee, but hey, every little bit counts, right? We want to head back to Faron and land at the bird statue on the tree, and the next one is just up the path located in the southeast corner. Now, one trick that I have is to place multiple beacons on your map, and as long as you're placing them relatively in the middle of the platform and they're all kind of lined up, then all you have to do is just line yourself up with the two beacons, and then you can jump off and you'll jump straight, and so you're guaranteed that you're going to land on the platform. It's kind of cool, huh? Now, alternatively, for this particular cube, you can also reach this one by latching onto the nearby targets once you have the claw shot. Now, the chest for this cube is found within the volcano island in the sky, and it's a little tricky to get to, though, so you may want to slow down with B before you actually dive off to make it a little bit easier. I'm going to glide your fall with a Wiimote to land on the upper platform within the volcano and open the chest to get a piece of heart. Now, the last cube in the Great Tree is a little more cleverly hidden. You may have been eyeing it if you are very observant, but it's to the far northeast in the direction of the temple, very close to an outstretching platform on the tree itself. Now, unfortunately, the walkway of the Great Tree is in the way, so we can't just jump down to it. However, if you look at it, you'll notice that it has a tightrope leading to another platform that you can see on your map as well. And the easiest way to do this is to stand close to the edge and press A to grab hold so that you're like holding on by your hands, and then you can move left and right until you're lined up with it, and then just drop. Next, you want to just balance across the tightrope and then strike the cube. Now, the related chest for this is within Thunderhead on a small island to the far top right of the dome, and there's some Waltulas that are in the way, so you need to dispatch them with either the beetle or the slingshot, and at this point, then you can just climb up the vines and open the chest to get the rupee metal, which makes rupees appear more often when you kill enemies, slash bushes, etc., so that's pretty cool. Before you go, you may also want to snag the nearby chest for some free treasure as well. So in the Faron region, while you're going through the Lake Floria area following this Perella, you'll have to jump onto this upper ledge, and there's a bird statue here that you should save at, so you can return here again if you need to. But anyway, there's a chest nearby that contains a treasure, and you can circle around the other way, and there's a goddess cube with your name on it. Now, the chest for this is only available a little later, though, once you've acquired the claw shots, and it's on top of the floating islands in the top right corner of the Skyloft. To reach it, you need to latch onto the vines of the smaller, lower island, then climb up, then latch onto the vines of the bigger island, and then climb on top of that. And then from here, you can look to the east, and then dive off the ledge to reach the far platform with the goddess chest on it that contains a gold rupee. Also, just after attaining the claw shots, there are two goddess cubes we can snag in Lanayru. The first one is to the far north, and you've probably been eyeing it for a while. To get there, you want to follow the path in the far top right corner of the map. You jump down onto the invisible road here under the sand, and then blow up the wall, and follow this path to the end where there's a chest containing a piece of heart. Now, the chest is actually available as soon as you arrive in Lanayru, but the cube is a different matter. You'll need to use the claw shots back and forth along the targets to eventually reach the ledge with the goddess cube on it. Now, the related chest for this is on an island in the top right corner of the sky between Bamboo Island and Bug Island. You want to jump down and swim through the water to reach a hidden cave. This is a great place to find fairies, which are pretty rare otherwise and are usually only found in dungeons. Of course, at this point in the game, it's a lot better to create better heart potions. You know, it's probably more valuable because you have so many hearts, but whatever. Anyway, this chest contains the second heart metal, which is excellent for all you hard mode players out there. Now, the other cube we can now access in Lanayru is to the south on top of one of the walls, and it's probably been driving you crazy up until now because you couldn't reach it, but the claw shots, we can now reach it. We want to latch onto the targets and then circle around and show that thing who's boss. This activates a chest on the familiar island just south of Thunderhead. You want to land, and you'll need to look for the vines between the two floating chunks of rock. You want to press A to drop down, and then follow the vines to reach the chest containing a life metal, which temporarily gives you a heart container while you wear it. This next cube is available as soon as you reach the Sandsea port. There's this area to the north that is closed off suspiciously, and you can climb the nearby metal crates and claw shot the target to the west. From here, you want to jump down and then run into the cavern to the north and kill the Araka larvae. Once you've dispatched them, you want to claim your three-dimensional square of the blue nature. Now, this chest is found inside the bazaar in Skyloft near Gondo's wart station, and because you may have explored this area on your first playthrough, been curious and such, Fee has an explanation on goddess chests when you first approach it. Now, technically, for later playthroughs, you probably won't come near this thing until you actually are opening the chest, at which point Fee's explanation is totally pointless. But anyway, she still has an explanation for you. This chest contains a gold rupee. Now, when you head to Skipper's Retreat to get the ancient sea chart, you cross over this bridge with a moblin, and just past this, you'll see an island in the distance with vines on the side. You want to latch onto it with the hookshots, and then climb around and use your hookshots again to reach the far island to the south that has a goddess cube on it. When ready to leave, just use the vines again to return. Back to this familiar island just south of Thunderhead, there's the final chest here is now activated. You want to use your hookshots to latch onto the vines on the ceiling of the cave that is on the opposite side, and this chest contains a potion metal, which increases the time that specific potions last. Some of them have a time limit on them. This is an awesome thing because it's really cool, actually, for boss battles in particular. Like, you can use stamina potions for the imprisoned, etc. Although, you can't use it inside Lineru's challenge, so that's kind of sad. For all his boss rush modes, you can't use any potions. That's pretty depressing. Once you have completed the pirate stronghold, the shark-like mouth opens, and you may have noticed that there's a platform above it that looks like it has something on top of it. And then just above the exit door of the stronghold itself, there is a target. You want to latch onto it, and then use the other target on the opposite side to reach the top, climb up to the platform, and then go strike your cube. This activates a chest that is on a big floating island in Skyloft, and again, to reach it, you need to use your hookshot to latch onto the vines of the lower island, and then from there, grab onto the vines of the bigger island, and this chest contains a piece of heart. There's also a single gratitude crystal up here at night. Now may be a better time to grab it than earlier, but you can get both of these things simultaneously if you come up here at night. You can get the crystal and the chest. So now that we have the claw shots, there's actually two goddess cubes in Faerûn that we can now reach. The first one is on top of the Skyview Temple entrance. Just to the right of the entrance itself, you can latch onto the vines above, and you can reach this upper ledge. You want to go left, and then latch onto the vines here too, and then climb up to reach a hidden cube. So this activates a chest that is on top of Beetle's Island to the northeast, but it's actually really hard to do. It is possible to dive into it, but it's very hard. To get there, what you need to do is go to Skyloft and enter Beetle's shop and sleep in his bed until night, and he'll take you to his island. Now his shop has a ladder outside of it that will allow you to jump into the alcove here, where he sleeps, I suppose. Not really sure why he has two beds, but anyway, the chest contains the second rupee metal. Now the other cube that we can find here in Faerûn is at the Lake Floria waterfall, just outside of the ancient cistern. If you're dowsing for goddess cubes at this point, this one is a little confusing because you can't quite tell which direction it's coming from, but it's on an upper ledge between the two exits here. You want to hookshot to the vines that are hanging down and climb up to strike the cube. So this one unlocks a chest that is just below Fun Fun Island and contains a gold rupee. So when traversing the volcano summit, you can go to this outside area to get water from a pool, and you'll notice that there are some suspicious vines that are leading down to the abyss, making it seem like you can use your claw shots there somehow. Now if you look on your map, you'll see that there's actually an island somewhere around where the base of where the vines are at, so that's kind of suspicious as well. Place a beacon there if you like, and then sprint off the ledge here. You want to tilt the Wiimote forward to glide down and go beyond the pillar. To find an island with a goddess cube on top of it. Yeah, so land on it and go strike the cube and then use the vines to get back. So this activates a goddess chest up on Bug Island within Thunderhead, and it's on the far western side that's on top of this wooden platform that's kind of hidden. To reach it, just go to the very top of the island and then walk out onto this castle-like extension thing and look down. And then just drop off the ledge and open up the chest to find a piece of heart. To get back, just claw shot the nearby vines. When you reach the Fire Sanctuary entrance, you want to enter the left tower and then climb up onto the windowsill straight ahead. From here, you can then use your hookshot on the vines straight ahead. You want to climb up and then latch onto the next island to the south, which has a single Lizalfos on it. Defeat it if you wish, then hookshot to the far south again to reach an upper platform with a goddess cube. Now the chest for this cube is on top of the Isle of Songs in Thunderhead and contains a small bomb bag. Kind of a shame that we don't get this free one so... You know, we get it so late in the game, but at the same time, I mean, we totally had ones for sale pretty early on, so whatever. I guess I'd rather have money. Now, this next one takes some explaining. Now, in Volcano Summit, there is a goddess cube on a chunk of rock in the lava. Now, during the Song of the Hero, there are platforms that are floating along in the lava that you can jump on to reach the cube, but at this point, you also have the True Master Sword, which has the upgraded Skyward Strike. This makes it charge up faster and also shoot further. With the extended range, you can then reach the cube from the land, as you saw in the video. Now, in a normal playthrough, you will probably only get this cube during the Elden portion of the Song of the Hero quest. However, if you play this game on hard mode, you get the upgraded Skyward Strike as soon as you get the Goddess Sword, meaning that this Goddess Cube is actually available earlier, and you can activate it right after getting the Fire Shield earrings, before you even approach the Fire Sanctuary, so that's quite a bit earlier. Kind of odd, but it doesn't really matter much because the chest for this cube isn't even available until after the Fire Sanctuary anyway, so I don't know. Doesn't really make much difference, I suppose. The final two chests are on this lone island in Thunderhead between the Isle of Songs and Bug Island. want to use the Magma Mitts so that you can dig down into the soft soil here to reach an underground scene with a Moldorm. Defeat it if you wish. There are two other holes down here, each of which leads to a chest. Correct one for this goddess cube is the bottom one, or rather, if you're following the walls, it'll be counterclockwise to reach this chest. Now it contains the final bottle of the game, which is somewhat excessive at this point, but it's great if you're having trouble with the final boss, because then you can have more potions on at once. The final goddess cube is in the Lumineru Gorge. Now as you make your way east to get the life tree sapling, you'll then see the goddess cube there on the ground, and because you'll sink in the sand, you need to charge up your Skyward Strike, so what you'll need to do is hit the Time Chest Stone first, and then drop down, and then strike the cube. The final chest is in the same location as the last one. You want to kill the Moldorm if you want, and then follow the walls clockwise this time to reach the last chest, and it contains a small quiver. Again, kind of a shame that we get this so late in the game, but when you're ready to leave, then just dig back into the hole and follow the walls counterclockwise. Well, folks, that's about it, and that's how you collect all 27 Goddess Cubes within The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. So hope you found this helpful, and if you ever need any more Legend of Zelda help, be sure to check out our website at zeldadungeon.net. Thank you for joining me, and have fun adventuring!